is the Lord, mightiest prophet of the Lord.
Amen. The Lord bless you, beloved listeners. The Lord Jehovah has spoken with me. Jehovah Elohim, the creator of Israel, the Lord who has chosen Jerusalem, who has chosen Israel, he that says, yes, Israel is the center of the earth, and Jerusalem is the center of the earth. Well, the Lord spoke with me yesterday, beloved people, yesternight, not this night, but the other night, about this big revival that has broken out in this country and beginning to get out of the borders. The Lord is speaking to me at this hour, and he did speak with me very, very mightily about this revival, and we have seen how humongous it has begun. It is a flame like a wildfire now that is consuming the church and the land, and it's a beautiful thing to behold. Now, the Lord in the same breath spoke with me yesterday at night about the healing service, the mega, massive, historic healing service that is coming up this coming Sunday, about 24 hours away from here or so, after this day, tomorrow, today being Saturday, it is about 5 minutes past midnight East African time now. And so the Lord has already spoken with me, and he has already made me live to see that day. There is going to be a tremendous, powerful, historic, mega healing service that will take place on Sunday. And again, the Lord has still restrained me. I will not leave. The Lord has restrained me to be where I am, where in Nairobi. But as the Lord has commanded, he has placed on my left hand, in the palm, on the hand, the leaves from the tree of life, a bunch of the leaves, and it's tremendous flourishing, and they flourished on my hand, as he placed, he plucked God the Father himself, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, Jehovah Elohim, Jehovah Adonai, as he plucked the leaves from the tree of life when he took me into the throne room. And then he brought me back with those leaves that he had placed in my hand at the throne room. Then the leaves flourished here tremendously in a very shocking manner. And it's big flourish, it's a big blossoming and flourishing. I can see some branches also growing. And then the Lord Jehovah told me, these are for the healing of the nations by voice, God the Father. And so this coming healing service on Sunday, the day after tomorrow, is going to be a big mega healing service. And this time around, I've already seen some healings. He has taken me to the poor neighborhoods of Africa, of Kenya here. And I see somebody whose left hand has died. Yes, it's died. It's not feeling anything. It looks like it has died. And he makes him speak with me from a small trading center in Kenya here. He speaks with me in the Rift Valley, by the way. He speaks with me, and he shows me the hand. It's dead. And then after that, I tell him it is well. And then at that time, the hand is brought back to life. So the Lord has commanded me to lift up my left prophetic hand before this nation and before the nations of the earth. And power will leave my hand when I do so on Sunday and visit people in a very massive way, extremely massive. It is going to be historic. And he will heal many, 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 many conditions. I've seen so many. There are the people of the Lord are suffering. There are people whose hands have died. They have lost feeling and touch and motion and connection, nerves. They are as good as dead hands they are carrying. The Lord made them show them to me. And the Lord has also shown me different other conditions in the land and beyond this land. And so there is going to be massive revival that breaks out. Already the end-time revival that brings in the Messiah has begun. And it's a tremendous wildfire. It's a fire that cannot be controlled, cannot be contained, cannot be restrained. It's a fire that will burn by the power of the Holy Ghost, the Holy Spirit. The latter holy revival of the Lord, the revival of holiness, is now at hand. And I know that you, the nations tuned in from abroad, outside, you have witnessed and watched how beautiful, how tremendously beautiful this end-time revival that has consumed Kenya is. And so the Lord has spoken with me about Sunday, that on Sunday, as I will stand before him and lift up my left prophetic hand, then power will come from that dreadful hand of the Lord and consume people in their churches with the mighty healing anointing of the Lord, which will descend with the power. The power of God will fall, essentially fall into those meetings. That in Kenya here, you are having joint services, so you're having very many people coming, even guests. The numbers are too big right now. People that have not been in this ministry, all of them now flooding in because they are sheep. And whenever sheep find where there's green pasture, they always call one another and go back there. That is just how innocent the sheep of Christ are. So there is going to be a very big, historic healing anointing of the Lord that will be released upon lifting of my left prophetic hand. And the Lord will again remove his people from shame, from pain and suffering, agony, trauma, all these things they've gone through over time. And the Lord is saying that at this time, as he does that, you can see what he's doing in Kenya. He's essentially cleaning out the church. They're recording the sick people. They're blind from their homes during the week. And then they bring them to the church, to the meetings. And then when they are healed, then the Lord now defeats the lie of the false prophets, the lie of the false apostles, the lie that had consumed the church, the cancer that had really eaten and brought malignancy into the church. But now the Lord is using this tremendous revival in Kenya at this hour to clean up the land, clean up the church in Kenya and beyond. And so I would like to encourage the nations from abroad to also tune into the same decree. It will be the same decree. And if I understand right, you even have better internet. You have better internet than Kenya here. Kenya, they have to buy little bundles and what and this to be able to tune into their churches. But for you abroad, you have more powerful internet. So the decree has greater clarity. You will receive it very well and more clearly. But I really encourage all the nations to tune in because there is no time. I have seen the Messiah coming. The Messiah is coming for a glorious church. So this is the hour when the Lord is beginning to revive the entire globe. So those of you from other nations, I really encourage you to tune in with your sick, because today we've received the news that in Finland, a pastor's wife that had urine incontinence, a severe one, where she was flowing, it was flowing and humiliating in Finland, then the Lord healed her. The Lord healed her on Sunday, this past Sunday, when I lifted up my left prophetic hand in Finland. She also received her healing. And we know very well the big healing of Anne-Marie, the dyslexia that is now a big wonder globally across the earth. She's now able to read. She's now able to read signs, to read books. And she's reading the Bible nonstop in the Facebook, on WhatsApp, on Twitter, on LinkedIn. It's amazing. It's an amazing, tremendous revival, beloved people. And it's a beautiful revival. And in the same Finland, we still have baby Amy. Amy, who had not walked, I think, is it up to 5 years? And he's now walking, and I'm speaking to the Lord about his speech, and I know he will speak. And so These are tremendous days, beloved people, regardless of first world or third world, regardless of developing or developed country. The Lord is visiting all nations. So I really encourage all the nations to plug in. As you can see, we have almost failed to fix the calendar for next year because it's unbelievably overcrowded. It has to be released. So this becomes the opportunity of your visitation to prepare the way for the glorious coming of the Messiah, to repent and turn away from sin and wickedness, to uphold the righteousness and the holiness of the Lord, to receive Christ Jesus as Lord and be born again and walk the narrow way, walk the narrow road, beloved people. So that's why I'm saying this is a tremendous opportunity for all the nations to tune in, even as the Lord speaks with Kenya, and you see he's doing a big thing. We don't know until now whether it's 120 cripples. We don't know the exact number of cripples that got up and walked this past Sunday. All we know is that we are reaching each of them, and it's unbelievable, each case. Each case is a tremendous story of Jesus, a beautiful story of Jesus, a mighty story of restoration, a tremendous and historic story of the end-time revival, the latter glory, the latter anointing, the latter reign, the latter authority that the Lord has released into the church. And you can see that in this mighty visitation, in this round, the Lord God the Father himself at the throne room is involved in this visitation. So this is a very landmark time. You could call it a watershed moment for the church, when the church really now has to make substantive decisions on her eternity, on this matter of obedience to righteousness, obedience to the holiness of the Lord. Again, I have seen historic healing that is going to take place this coming Sunday, and it's going to be an avalanche, a flood of healing, a tsunami wave. It's going to come in waves and waves and waves and continuous, nonstop. And so many people are going to be healed in this land. Tremendous number of people will be healed in Kenya, but those tuned in from abroad, you to have the same capacity, same opportunity to receive from the Lord and receive your healing as we still work out the calendars to visit you. Somehow we sort of have Portugal, we have Peru in the radar, and we have Australia, and probably Hong Kong, Malaysia. These are the possible targets, and UK, but it's still too tight. However, now is the moment to have your visitation in your land, to have you receive your visitation of the latter glory of the Lord, the visitation of the end time, beloved people. What a tremendous opportunity that now the Lord can reach you in the comfort of your nation, in the comfort of your home churches, that as you gather and you tune in, and the Lord can visit you people, because Kenya is moving higher and higher. The Lord is promising even greater and higher. But this is open to all the other nations, to the entire body of Christ, beloved people. And the Bible says that they brought unto the Lord Jesus, they brought unto him people that were sick of all kinds of diseases, and he healed them all. He healed them all. And you see, this is what is happening now. This is what the Lord is doing at this hour. This is what God the Father has now instructed at this hour, that he's healing them from the tumors to the cripples, to the blind, to the cancers, diabetes, conditions, everything, anything, parts in the stomach, parts in the liver, everything is dropped. I am announcing the latter glory of the Lord that is pouring down. He's going to pour it on Sunday when I lift up my left prophetic hand, the dreadful hand of the Lord, and is going to visit the body of Christ in a big way, regardless of boundary. If Finland can receive that far, 1,700 plus kilometers away, really, really, there is no boundary. If Ivory Coast could receive, if Maputo, Mozambique could receive, so surely this is the hour for your visitation, beloved people. The message of righteousness is clear. The message of return to holiness is clear. The message of zero tolerance to sin is clear. The message of living a stringent Christian lifestyle, walking the narrow road, to forget about the movies, to kick out all those football games, whatever he used to do, to stay away from those parties, beer parties, and what have you, and to walk a tight walk, owing to the cost of the salvation that we received. And so, beloved people, I have seen the Messiah coming. The Father has spoken with me very clearly about the coming of the Messiah, His one and only Son, the one that is sent to bring us the grace of our Lord Jesus. I have seen the Lord Jesus coming, the Messiah coming, and this is the hour, the opportunity before the door closes for the nations to shun sin. Look at the power of repentance in Kenya. Look at just how much the power of repentance can revive the church. Look at the tremendous fact that when the Lord sent me to Kenya and Kenyans received repentance and they accepted to change their ways, and those that changed their ways, now they're seeing the big fruit. The Lord has given me the leaves. He has placed on my hand the leaves of the tree of life, and He has also shown me the wonderful, huge, beautiful fruit of the leaves from the tree of life when I lift up my left prophetic hand. So, beloved people, prepare the way the Messiah is coming. Prepare the way the King of Glory is coming. The Lord Jesus, the Lord Christ is coming. And these are the signs of the coming of the Messiah, the latter glory that would be unleashed, that would be much greater than the first reign. So all the nations, regardless of boundary, regardless of first world or third world or second world or which world, whatever the nation, regardless the color, the race, you can all partake of this glory and prepare the way and live a life of adventure with the Lord. The way you see now, God the Father is traversing this land of Kenya, touching people physically, removing tumors, the ear, the vessels cutting, eyes are being touched with sand and cleaning up, the eyes opening and everything, very mysterious, miraculous wonder is happening in this land. So you too can partake of this in your countries. The Messiah is coming, beloved people. Again, for those in Kenya, make sure that the medical teams are out tomorrow. They go to the villages, pull out all the cripples, bring out the cripples, bring out the blind, examine them, record them, document them. It's very important to document them very well, as they are not able to walk when they are still on the dust, on the ground, and try to get up and collapse and all this. And the blind, they can't see, the deaf can't hear. Pull them out, the tumors, the diseases. Pull them out and document them. Let the medical teams document them very well and then assemble them on Sunday, because the Lord is going to heal them en masse in their largest numbers, and it will be stunning to see their initial condition and now when they are healed. That is the glory of the Lord Jesus. That is the glory of God the Father. That is the glory of the Holy Spirit, my one and only friend. May the Lord bless you, precious people. May the Lord bless you, the people of the earth. The Messiah is coming. Thank you and shalom.